and a pleasant good afternoon to you and yours, and welcome to Palm Bay Pirate Stadium here on the campus of Palm Bay High School, where today it's a beautiful day for football, and we've got five of the best youth football games around on tap for you today. In case you're just joining us and you're wondering, what have I missed? It's 1:42, nothing. The cheer competition ran a little long, and we'd like to extend a big-time congratulations to the grand champion, Bayside Bears. We had Vero Beach win a title. We had Titusville win a title. Cocoa win a title. Bayside win two titles. So congratulations to all of the cheerleaders. If you want to see the end of that, you can go to Caleb Brown's Facebook page. I believe you have that up, right?
Some of the titles being produced.
But today we begin with the Flag Super Bowl for the ACYAA, as we have the Merritt Island Mustangs going up against the Vero Beach Fighting Indians. And the Merritt Island Mustangs are led by head coach Joshua Dotson, assistant coaches Dwan Ballard, Christian Cuellar, James Jeffers, Michael Pilo, O'Brien Sherman. That's as many coaches as they got on an NFL squad. And for Vero, the head coach is Alan Johnson. The assistant coach is Corey Glanville, Travis Marshall, and the team parent is LaShonda Johnson. I don't see a team parent for, there are three more coaches for Merritt Island. The Travis Smiley, Coach Smith, and a team parent is Michaela Connors and Casey Cuellar. So well represented are the Merritt Island Mustangs, as Vero Beach will play in one of three games today. West Melbourne will also participate in three, Cocoa in two, and Titusville in the 14U game. As we get set for the Flag game, we got a coin toss here. Now, I believe Flag is different for every league that I've broadcast this year, from Pop Warner to the MFFCC to the ACYAA. Thank you, Caleb. It's a lot of initials. It looks like they play on a 100-yard field.
No?
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. Sorry. I see the, 80-yard field. It's an 80-yard field. Here comes the coin toss. Now, we have tried to hook up the Switcher Studio application, but Palm Bay so touch and go with the signal down here. We may be able to get it up later. We're going to effort that between games, where you can have the scoreboard and the things. But today's games are brought to you by Zone 6. Check out Zone 6 at zone6reapers.com. 7-on-7 registration taking place now. BlackRock Engineering and Technology, the best in cyber security. Five games on tap for you here today. I want to say congratulations to the Cocoa Tigers, the high school Cocoa Tigers. Last night they advanced to the regional finals for the 16th year in a row, and they will take on South Sumter next week, as the Melbourne Bulldogs fall to Vero Beach last night and Holy Trinity falls to PK Young. As we get set for Flag action here, running about 40 minutes behind, but you know what? We could run 2 hours and 40 minutes behind, and that would be just fine, because the cheerleaders deserve as much time as they got. And congratulations to the Bayside Bears, the grand champions today. And here come the Merritt Island Mustangs as they look to finish an outstanding season here in the ACYAA, as the Vero Beach team gets set to take the field. And here they come. Of course, Merritt Island and black, and Vero will be dressed in all black. V Vero will be on offense first. 15 minutes on the clock. Like to say hello to everybody watching here. Gloria Willis, Neil Robb. Say hello to Jackson Forrest, Neil. Double D, Daryl Durand, Mary Lou Da Rosa Levitzi, and Sean Heath, all watching here today on Brevard Sports Network. I want to thank everybody. We just hit in all of our social media. I counted last night between Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube, 27,000 followers. I'd like to say good morning or good afternoon to Miss Cheryl Abdelis as well. And say hello to Stephanie Castellanos. I know I'm butchering that. And that's just a shame that I would butcher any last name, considering mine is Slaughterzinski. But here we go. First and 10 for Vero Beach. The offense takes the field. Now, the coach made a comment on social media the other day that he really firmly believed, and I'm putting this mildly, that his team would win today. So we'll see as Vero takes on Merritt Island here in the ACYAA Flag Super Bowl. We'll be with you all day and night here. Man in motion from the gun. And, yep. Flags fly. I am going to say this. I was utterly impressed with that cheer competition. Blown away by the amount of fans and support in the stands. I mean, I've never seen those stands on the other side of the field as filled as they were. Not for a Florida Tech football game, not for a Palm Bay football game. So congratulations to the ACYAA and their absolutely fantastic cheer programs. This is a jet sweep here, and this could be trouble as he is at the 40, cuts back again, and he'll go down. That is number two. That's Tito Quintero Jr. How about Tito? Tito Quintero Jr., May 4th, 2016 birthday. My goodness gracious, 2016. Jeez. If only I could be that young again. But no sense in rehashing my life. First and 10 from the Vero Beach 45. Number five tries to get, oh, what a move, and what a flag pull there. Get the number on that young man, because that's as good of a flag pull as you'll see. That's Caleb Cuellar on the flag pull. Cannon Marshall, my bad. Thank you. I got number two as Cannon Marshall, the quarterback. We just are underway. I'll give the score every 90 seconds, so you don't save your fingers from typing. I'll make sure you get the score in the time. This is Cannon again. Cannon cuts it back again. Gets outside. Cuellar misses the flag that time. Cuts it back and out. Look at this Barry Sanders-type move. He's still on his feet. Flag eventually pulled. What a move by Cannon. 13:20 to go, just underway. Opening possession of the football game. Is my man watching? Hawk. So, number five is Johnson. Allen Johnson is the quarterback. You sure it's five, not two?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, I got it. Oh, he's under center. I see it. All right. He goes down on the knee. He loses 2 yards. So Vero in a 4th-and-9 situation with 12:39 to play. Opening possession. And he just slipped and fell there. And big play coming up here for the Merritt Island defense. Quarterback. Oh, you're going to throw it. Man, he takes about a 6 step. Oh, look at that arm. Caught. What a catch. What a throw. Cannon Marshall, and that is as good as you'll see at really any age level. 26 yards and a first down. Allen Johnson to Cannon Marshall, and Vero Beach is in business. First and 10 from the Merritt Island 35. Quarterback keeper that time. How about that play, huh? Wow. Tell me the last time you saw a 30-yard pass completion in flag football. He threw that over the top of cover four. Second and 8. Allen in trouble here. Gets out of it once, gets out of it twice, can't get out of it 3 times. As number 3 proudly holds up the prize. The flag pool there. That is Trevor Esau. And with 10:57 to play here. Oh, beautiful. God bless you. Cannon Marshall, Osceola. Oh, look at this. What's your name? Nicole what? Nicole what? I want to thank Nicole Peters, who just brought me the most unbelievable roster you could have. This is, looks like Cannon Marshall again. Cannon gets outside, cuts it back. Look at this young man. Still cuts it outside again. Cannon Marshall at an Osceola Magnet school. Thank you, Nicole. Where's the rest of the programs at? Come on up. Be happy to take it. Allen Johnson, Travis Marshall, Corey Glanville. Coaches, I'd like to welcome in Bill Palmer. Watch it, Bill Palmer Sr., that is. You can always tell them apart on Facebook because one's Bill, one's Billy. And this is the quarterback, and he is going to score a touchdown. Touchdown, Vero Beach. Allen Johnson, the Rosewood Magnet School product, gets in the end zone. And with 9:37 to play here in the opening half quarter, it's 6-0 Vero Beach. What a drive. We saw a little bit of everything on that drive. Saw some jet sweeps, saw some straight dives, and a 30-yard pass play, the catalyst for that one. Johnson to Marshall. NFL teams could take note on that drive. 9:06. Marshall going to get outside. He's got a shot here. He gets outside again, and flag is pulled by number 8 for Merritt Island. And 6-0 Vero Beach on top. We'll also keep the score in the comments section for you as well, as that flag was pulled by James Jeffers. So what we'll do is we'll let you know who scored, how they scored. So that was Allen Johnson. On a 23-yard touch, on actually it's 13 yards. 13-yard TD run. 6-0 Vero. And here come the Mustangs. What does Coach Dotson have in store for Vero here? We are an interactive broadcast. Feel free to comment. Let us know where you're watching from. We always give shout-outs. We carry on conversations. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. Just not the score. And that ball hits the ground, and the whistle blows the play dead. 7:31 to go. Ricky Kendall says, let's go, Junior. Which one's Junior? Tell me who Junior is. 7:22. And here comes Merritt Island again, second and about 13 for the Mustangs. They are in black and yellow, moving right to left. on your handheld device. Ball on their own 33-yard line. Whistles. Offsides on Vero. That's your nephew. Okay, Lance Gerhart Jr. All right. So he is number 14 out there. So that'll be second and eight now for Merritt Island. Straight up I formation here. Sort of. Quarterback turns, gives. That's a lot of speed right there. Let me tell you something. Is that Allen? No, that's Cannon Marshall. Cannon Marshall gets in there, and I believe he's going to say that he encroached the Oh, that's against Merritt Island. He's just that fast. He is just that fast. He's tired of that step. What's that? That's what he did. I'm trying to figure out what the call was. Anyway. No. It was the official call. Second and 20. For Merritt Island. I'm not sure what that call was. Turns, gives, and that's just not going to cut it against Vero. You're just not going to be able to run east and west. And when they start getting on that side of the field, my old eyes will begin to fail me. Number three on the stop there for Vero Beach. That is Jaquime Bennett. Queen Bennett. Say hello to my man Xavier Alexander. If he's here today, you got to get over there and get you a lemonade. Get over there and get a lemonade. The best in the biz. Are they not, Caleb? This is number eight on the carry, and he tries to get outside. Flag. That's a Vero flag out. He cuts back. That's a whole lot of running for not a lot of yards. And that's a good effort by James Jeffers, but here's something I've noticed pretty fast here. You're not running east and west on Vero Beach. 4 minutes to play in the first quarter. 6-0 Vero on top, thanks to an Allen Johnson touchdown run. You're just not going to run east and west on this defense. And look how they're spread out. Eight across. You try to run past that. Turns, gives, and they converge again. But that's it. No, actually, it's a nice handoff. Cuts back. Number four that time for Vero. Pulls the flag. That's Makai Kennedy at a Dodger Town Elementary. Love the name of that school. Watch your foot. Dodger Town Elementary. Makai. So that's a turnover on downs, and the ball goes back to Vero Beach. 2:54 to play in the opening quarter. 6-0. Vero on top. Turns, gives. Look at that move. Quick outside. And he, if he turns the corner, nope. Nice cutoff there. Good flag pull. Nice pull by Darian Ballard.
Right now, right?
First and 10. Ball at the 15-yard line. And that's a penalty against Merritt Island. So it'll be first and 5 now. Ball at the 10-yard line. Well inside the zone 6 Reaper red zone here. 1:26 to play. Johnson under center. He's going to roll right. Merritt Island cuts it off nicely, but the stutter steps. Can he get there? Yes, indeed. Touchdown. His second of the game, Allen Johnson scores. No? Did it, one referee put his arms up, didn't he?
He did, but then he reversed his decision when the kid showed him the flag.
Oh, kid had his flag. Okay. All right. One ref says touchdown. The other kid says, no, I had his flag. So it's not a touchdown, but it is first and goal from the 2. So my apologies there. That's the, I believe it's the end of the quarter. No, 53.7 seconds to go. So, Vero, knock, 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 and on. Pay Dirt's door here with 53.7 seconds to play in the first quarter. And it's 6-0. Vero with the ball and the lead and first and goal. Looking to put the Mustangs in a deep early hole. This is Cannon Marshall again. Marshall had his flag pulled. Nice job there. Good goal line defense. That's number 45 for Merritt Island. That's Keon Knighton. So Knighton with the pull. And now that'll back him up a half yard. It'll be second down and goal. And we got a whistle and another timeout. This one called by Merritt Island. So with 21.1 seconds to play here in the first quarter and a 6-0 Vero lead, Merritt Island elects to take a timeout. I'd like to welcome in Frank Johnson, Corey Burnside, C.J. Sackleford, Al Capo, Logan Futch, Lori Fiorito, Elizabeth Michelle Daly, Kushan DeMay, and my man Nick Narciso, all watching here on Brevard Sports Network. And again, my man Damian Alexander's watching. And is that his lemonade stand over there? And here we go. And that is a touchdown for Vero. And that is Allen Johnson again, the Rosewood Magnet product. Gets in for his second of the day, and his time continues to expire here in the first quarter, and it will. And there it is. That's the end of the first quarter. They'll get to run the extra point here. It's 12-0 pending the extra point, and Vero Beach looks unstoppable at the moment. Congratulations again to the Bayside Bears. They are the grand champion of the ACYAH year. Johnson making plays. That's all he does. And he does it again as he gets in for the conversion. So Allen Johnson is responsible for all 13 Vero Beach points. And, well, the offensive line, a big help too. And as we start quarter number 2 here, it is 13-0 Vero Beach. We'll be right back. All right, welcome back. Nikita Smith says, that number five is one heck of a player. Yes, indeed he is. There is no doubt about that. As we get set for the start. That's halftime? Oh, well, tells you what I know about the rules. All right, that's halftime.
I was like you. I thought we were ready to start a second quarter.
Okay. So. Yeah, that's what it looks like.
I haven't done 60 in a while, so I don't remember either.
So halftime, 13-0. Back in 5 minutes. All right, I may not, 12-0 as halftime gets set to end here. You know, a lot of times at this age group, you don't get an opportunity. Not all the kids touch the football. Well, that's true at every age group. But so we want to make sure that both of these teams, we get to call or say their names at least once here on the broadcast. So for the Vero Beach Flag Team 6U, Jaquim Bennett, he's number one. He goes to Osceola Magnet School. Cannon Marshall, number two. He also attends Osceola Magnet. Zechariah Robinson, number three, another Osceola Magnet school product. Makai Kennedy goes to Dodgertown Elementary. Alan Johnson, number five, Rosewood Magnet. Makai Robinson, number six, Glendale Elementary. Aiden Pearson, number nine, Osceola Magnet. Jaden Zendejas, number 12, out of Fellsmere Elementary. Royal Bell, number 13, out of Rosewood Magnet. Brandon Preston, number 16, out of Dodgertown Elementary. Ricky Lloyd, doesn't have a school for him, but his hometown is Gifford. Christian Rivers, number 24, Dodgertown Elementary product. Jameer Clark, number 33, St. Peter's Academy. And the coaches are Alan Johnson, Travis Marshall, and Corey Glanville. And the team mom is LaShonda Johnson. As Merritt Island gets set to take the field, and we'll give you Merritt Island here in just a second. Merritt Island, double zero is Casey Cuellar's Caper. Number one is Darian Ballard. Number two is Keyshawn Simmons. Three is Trevor Esau. Four is Maxwell Sherman. Five, Michael Pilo. Six, James Jeffers. Seven, Roman Salter. Eight, Josiah Gonzalez. Nine, Cameron Shields. Ten, Yeshua Patterson. 11, Wesley Salter. 12, Cage Dukes. 14, Lance Gerhardt Jr. 16, Amir Smith. 17, Terrence Norris. 21, Frank Walton Jr. 33, Caleb Cuellar. 34, Kyron Knighton. 45, Kyron Knighton. So Kyron's got two numbers. One of them is not Kyron Knighton. That's the roster I have. So we got a second and 10 here following that snap. 13-0. Vero on top. 14:43 to play in the game. And actually, he didn't hand it off. Gets outside. He's got space. First down. Still on his feet. Twist and turns. Still going. Great run there by Josiah Gonzalez. And the flag was pulled there by Bennett. Jaquim Bennett. And it's first and 10, and this is the best offensive play of the day so far for the Merritt Island flag team. They have first and 10 at the Vero Beach 45, 35 actually, because it's play on 80-yard fields. So this will be the 35-yard line you're looking at. The 10-yard line is the touchdown marker. Coming up next, it'll be 8U. That's Vero Beach as well. And Coco, as Coco steps onto the track. Turns, gives. Stutter steps. What a move. Outside, inside. And flag pulled. That's a gain of 6, maybe 7. That was Jeffers, or I'm sorry, that was not. That was Darian Ballard on the carry. Darian Ballard. Ballard with a good run there. They give him 5. So it'll be second down and 5 for Merritt Island. Ball at the Vero Beach 30-yard line. Second and 5 for the Mustangs. That's a false start, legal motion. And that'll back them up. It'll be second and 10. Ball moved back to the 35, 12, 17 to play in the game. The trick here is Merritt Island's only going to get two possessions here, and they've got to make them count as they trail 12 to nothing here. 12 to nothing. Okay, somebody's a little horn happy. Straight up I formation. Nice flag pull. That's a loss of 4 yards and a great flag pull there by number 21 for Vero. I don't have number 21 on the roster for Vero Beach. Possible it could have been 24 Christian Rivers. That's Christian Rivers down there. What is that? Okay. So now it's third down and 12, and they got to make this count. That is for sure. Nice block. See that block? But it does not matter. Because Jaquean Bennett pulls the flag, and it's 4th and 8 following a gain of 4. 10:29 to play in the game. I'd like to say hello to Tristan Andrews, George Harris, Markel Gowans watching. Markel with an outstanding season for the Palm Bay Pirates. And Trey Graham. Palm Bay last night fell to Coco, but there were definitely parts of that game where at Coco secondary and that pass rush did a nice job. Last night, Markel, big part of that. 4th down and 8. And there's a flag and another false start. So Merritt Island shooting themselves in the foot a little bit here. And the Mustangs are going to take a timeout, settle down a little bit here, because with 9:30 to go, this really is, you know, the proverbial nail in the coffin play here, right? I mean, they don't make this with 9:30 to play. That's pretty much it. And I think the coaches know the importance of this play as Vero Beach and Coco line up. We got a good 8U game coming up next. A good 8U game coming up next. Yeah. Undefeated Vero Beach. Coco's not undefeated?
Not that I'm aware of.
Okay.
The announcer said Vero Beach was undefeated.
Okay. The Vero Foundation is an outstanding program. To make it this far is quite an accomplishment for all of these teams. And George Harris hit the nail on the head. And that was quite an effort there. Good try by Josiah Gonzalez, but that's going to be a turnover on downs. And here comes Vero Beach. Every time they've touched the ball today, they've put it in the end zone. To do so again would wrap up the championship. I like the way those Coco uniforms look, man. Have to have a talk with Ryan Schneider. It's a handoff, number 4 here. Look at that move. Oh, that should be a flag. Nope, it's not. Number 4 with a good run there. Thought he tackled him there. It's Makai Kennedy at Dodgertown Elementary. Number one pulls the flag. That is Darian Ballard. So far, our player of the game's got to be Allen Johnson, the quarterback. Kenna Marshall with a good game, too, here for Bureau. But welcome in Nikki Nicole, George Harris, Tiffany Jackson, all watching here today on Brevard Sports Network. This is a give to number 24. He stumbles through, trips. He'll pick up a yard. That's Christian Rivers. Also attends Dodgertown Elementary. 7:30 to play in the game. We've kind of seen this from this Vero offense, struggling on first and second down, and then third and fourth down is where all the explosiveness takes place. Nobody in the backfield as they seal off the blocks. Merritt Island has made an adjustment, but Allen Johnson says, you know what, look at this move. Look at this move. The move is phenomenal. Cost himself a yard, but the moves are eye-popping. Flag pulled by Josiah Gonzalez, who's battling out there for the Mustangs. So this is fourth down. So all hope not lost yet for the Mustangs. They get a stop here. But the last time Vero faced a fourth down, all Allen Johnson did was complete a 29-yard pass to Cannon Marshall. And this time, Johnson, everybody's on the line of scrimmage. Fourth and six. Uh-oh. Does he have the edge? Ballard tries to cut him off. There goes Allen. Down the sidelines. Flag pulled. This time it's not a 30-yard pass, but a 30-yard run by Allen Johnson. And with 6:07 to play, Vero Beach is inside the Zone 6 Reaper Red Zone again. First and 10 at the 15-yard line. That little stutter step he does. Well, I was getting ready to say, if the Melbourne Bulldogs are watching, this is what you have to contend with for the next 10 years once they get to high school. Melbourne, of course, falling to Vero Beach last night. And the young man played quarterback for Vero last night, and E.J. Johnson, who we saw play 14U here a couple of years ago and absolutely tore West Melbourne up. This is Cannon Marshall. Look at Cannon. Look at this move. Cannon's going to score. There is nobody home. Touchdown, Vero Beach. That'll ice the game on an outstanding move. And with 5:05 to play, the 15-yard touchdown by Cannon Marshall at an Osceola Magnet makes it 19-0. How about that run? Here comes the extra point try. Ball start.
The back got a little excited that he was going to have the ball thrown to him.
Yeah. Kind of gave the play away and false started all in one fell swoop there.
Yet also had everybody beat.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. Got him beat again. Look, wide open. All he's got to do is throw it. Oh, off the hands of Cannon. Nice try, though. Nice try. 3:50 to play. 19-0, Vero Beach. Back in just a moment. All right, Merritt Island now. A pride drive, we call this. Playing for pride here with 3 minutes to play in the game. 3 minutes to play. Goodness gracious, Cannon Marshall is going to be flagged, but what an effort by that young man. He dove after that flag. And congratulations to Vero Beach, Jaqueen Bennett, Cannon Marshall, Zakiya Robinson, Makai Kennedy, Allen Johnson, Makai Robinson again, Aiden Pearson, Jaden Zendejas, Royal Bell, Braden Preston, Rick Lloyd, Christian Rivers, Jameer Clark, coaches Allen Johnson, Travis Marshall, and Corey Glanville, and the team mom, LaShonda Johnson. They will be your ACYAA flag champs. We're going to log off immediately after this and get set for the 8U game coming up between Vero and Coco. Super Bowl Saturday. I want to thank Billy Palmer and the entire ACYAA board for once again inviting Brevard Sports Network back for a third year here. A third year we have. Actually, for the last 3 years, we have been the primary broadcasters for the ACYAA Super Bowl. We've been the primary broadcasters for the MFFCC Super Bowls. And we have done several Pop Warner Super Bowls. We did it last year for Satellite, the year before for Vieira. We also did it for Portage, Indiana. We're going to do it for Portage, Indiana again this year. And a couple of years ago, we actually did it for a team out of Chicago, Illinois. And, yeah, two teams out of Chicago, actually. So, second down and four for Merritt Island. 1:39 to play. Clock is stopped after the timeout. Nothing I enjoy more than these days. Great move. Now, if we're telling truths, 90 seconds to play. If we're telling truths, it's a little rough sometimes getting up to do a game at 8 o'clock in the morning on a Saturday after we go to bed at 5 o'clock in the morning from a football Friday night, right? I mean, it, you know, that's a little rough, but it's always just well worth it.
It's just getting there, because once we're there, we're good.
Speak for yourself.
Once I get
takes
there,
me to about noon to get cranked up.
I'm good when I get there. It's just the act of getting up.
Right. 1:01 to play. Under a minute here now as Vero Beach begins the celebration. On the sidelines there, the young players over there are happy. That ball is way up and incomplete. And clock continues to roll here. So Vero 1-for-1 today. Merritt Island will take a timeout here. And I don't blame them. The referees are jumping like, please stop the clock. And finally, they do. And we went through the Vero Beach team, and these young men from Merritt Island have done a terrific job this year. So let's say their names one more time. Julian Capers, Darian Ballard, Keyshawn Simmons, Trevor Esau, Maxwell Sherman, Michael Pilo, James Jeffers, Roman Saluter, Josiah Gonzalez, Cameron Shields, Yeshua Patterson, Wesley Salker, Cage Dukes, Lance Gerhart Jr., Amir Smith, Terrence Norris, Frank Walton Jr., Caleb Cuellar, and Kyron Knighton and Keon Knighton. Kyron and Keon, they're brothers. Could be. And outside and down to the 25. And it'll be first and 10 for Merritt Island. There's a referee's flag down on the field. See what this is about as the clock continues to roll. Good run there. And that'll do it. So congratulations to the Vero Beach Fighting Indians as they win 19-0, and confetti is spread all over the field.
I like it.
Yeah, I do too. So we'll be back in about 10 minutes here on Brevard Sports Network. We're going to turn the volume down, and we'll let you see the trophy presentation because they play music and we don't want to get blocked. So we'll stay here through the trophy presentation. We'll turn it off, and then we'll be back for the 8U game.